type your answer in the chat, because I realize sometimes we're not. Oh, is this not an interactive slide? Did I delete this one? Yeah, it is. So the hold on 1 second. Okay, yeah, we're recording. So we've got that, and then let me, not that one. So we have quite a few, third through fifth, right? Sixth through eighth, ninth through 12. Well, the chat just opened up huge. Okay, a couple others. So can you guys, are you guys able to see everyone's responses here? If you want to put that in the chat, yeah. So let me ask you a question. Is anyone lost in a window yet right now? Are you lost in a window or in a tab or anything, right? Yeah, you cannot, we can't see everyone's responses on the mobile device. So that's one thing Peardeck doesn't have yet, but I can imagine that that can go. But can you see everyone's responses on my Zoom screen, right? If you're looking. So really the goal for me is you answer here and then you get responses to look right here. So all I got to do is this. All I need is a mobile here. And I understand that not every student is going to have a phone, but this could be more useful for like PD, like, you know, with adults. So that's just one way, you know, but a lot of kids do have phones. But it's a nice, the main thing I want to get across is like, this is super, should be super low stress because no one is having to jump from tabs to tabs, and I can like engage, answer a question here, and then I can move on. So let me ask a question. Another multiple choice. So that was a multiple choice question. This one is also multiple choice. What grade do you teach? And I'm just going to show this response there. So we got a lot. Oh, Google Slides is out in the lead. Google Slides is out in the lead. PowerPoint got a late start, and Google Slides is on some performance enhancing technology tool right now, I think. So yeah, Slides is free. You know what I mean? So here's the nice thing is Peardeck works on both. So, I'm not sure what the other is, but Peardeck works on as an add-on for Google Slides and for PowerPoint. And I'm going to show you guys towards the end, I'm going to show you guys a demo on how to do this and how easy this really is to like add this hot sauce to your Peardeck, to your slide. This is a number response. So this amazing GIF is from Design Saunders. If you guys know that guy, you guys got to give that shout out. Like, how many Zooms on average per day are you in, right? How many Zooms on average? So, and this is key because, let me see. Allison, I'm not sure if it works on gaming consoles. Well, it'll work. Yeah, it'll work. You add the Peardeck to your Google Slides and your PowerPoint. And then however they access it on the internet, like I'm just doing this on my phone. So you send them the Peardeck link and then you can run this through there. And Powitz, is it Carla? Meets count as Zooms. Yes. Yes. So we're gonna lump that together, right? I don't do the Google Meet though. I'm a Google vegan, right? I'm going Google vegetarian. So I don't do the meats. Google Churrascaria. Okay. So let me see. So here's this. Now look at this. You're always gonna get some wisecracker that is gonna say like, I'm in a million, whatever, Zooms, a bajillion, but I'm gonna find out who that is. And the nice thing is I could put you on blast right now, young man, young woman. And I will find out who you are. And I know, I know you. Mm-hmm. So, and what I can do is, let let me see, I locked that. And what I did is before I showed people, like, because if you're a math teacher, you're loving this feature right here with the numbers response, which is a free feature because Katie, I didn't say names, Katie. I didn't say names. Kurt, you know, the Valley, Central Valley. I'm just saying we got some crazy teachers. That's awesome. We got to keep it lively. Right. So, but the nice thing is, like, you know, not that your kids would ever like put inappropriate responses. You know, I know only my students have done that. Crazy good teachers, Angela. Good to see you here. But if someone like throws in a number like that, then it's going to totally skew the visual of the right of this box and whisker plot. Cause like, like I was saying, as a math teacher, like we get to reinforce median, upper quartile, lower quartile, the range, all of this. This is like great, you know, and just doing, how easy is this? And you're not lost in a window, I don't think, right? You're still not lost. But the nice thing is I can go on the dashboard and I can see, oh, this Kern County Q member put in a bajillion zooms, you know? So then I just remove that one, that outlier, boop, fixes my data right there, right? So that's nice. And don't worry about that. I'm gonna have you guys draw. Now this is let's do this one. What is the best strategy or tool that's been working for you with distance learning? Like, this is the text response now. And I'm gonna give you guys a minute for that one. Play a little music for that one. So we're getting our groove on now.
People want to know how you're putting the music in.
I have a mixer that I bought. So I have an audio mixer that that's connected to my mic, and my audio goes in. But I'm playing remotely. I'm running the like Spotify from my phone, but it plays on my computer. That's like, you know, because my mixer was like $150, $175 or something. But an easier way to do that, like as long as you have a Bluetooth speaker, keep a Bluetooth speaker somewhere near your microphone so that the audio will pick up on the mic. So, yeah, Lisa, we'll do a mixer session, maybe at a midnight pedagogy coming to you, right, Victoria? Yeah, Bluetooth speakers, though, is a good hack, like, for sure. Like, because sometimes this doesn't work, and sometimes I don't have my mixer, and I'm not in this office, so I just do the Bluetooth speaker. I carry my Bluetooth speaker with me everywhere, and I just keep it somewhere close, have the speaker pointing up, like under my chin. And then I just get to DJ here. If you use Spotify, I don't know. I mean, most of those other ones, you can just connect it. So, yeah. So, okay. So let me show you. So here are the responses. This is the text response, right? I can show all the responses. And at first they're here like in the list form, which is cool, but it's going to take forever to scroll through. If you look up here in the corner, it has grid layout, list layout, and grid layout. If you guys see that, the grid layout is my favorite for the text responses, at least right here, because I can get a great snapshot of everybody right here. I will say like, oh yeah, jam board is the jam. I'm going to say right here, whoever did this, you are on the money with that Calendly. My God, that is the tool for sanity, for scheduling stuff, like totally worth the money. Calendly. So Nearpod, webcam. And I mean, at the end, I'd love to have a conversation about Nearpod versus Peardeck, because I've never really used Nearpod. I just started using Peardeck and I really like it and it's easy, but I know they do a lot of the same things. And I know that Nearpod does a lot of other cool extra things. So I'm just curious about that. You know, I'm not going to say one or the other. I'm just going to say this is the one I like and I use because it's kind of simple. I'm simple. Okay, so what I want you to do is let's get your artist skills going on right now. Draw. What does Zoom fatigue look like? Or when you've been Zoomnadoed, cat, like Victoria said, cat nine Zoomnado. So like, let's see what kind of artistic skills you guys have. I'll give you some. Ooh, Midnight Pedagogy had a head-to-head. Yep, bro.
Today is gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now.
Oh, man.
Backbeat, the word is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you've heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now.
All right. So just for the sake of time, I want to make sure I get everything going. Sandhya, I'm sorry. Here, I'll unlock it so you guys can continue drawing. You can zoom in on your phone, like if, you know, just pinch it and you can zoom in and get a little. You can also, there's a little slide ruler on the left side that lets you choose the width of your pencil. So that's easier. I like to drag that one down a little bit lower because it's pretty thick. It's like Sharpie, you know, Sharpie status when you start. So like, hopefully you're getting some ideas like how you can use this, like with some of the content that you are using, whether it's drawing over a map, right? And all this is a Google slide. And I found a nice frame image of an Instagram picture. You can fill in the space, you can type the text. I like right here, they realize like you don't, the nice thing about this is you can draw and text, you know, and have some shapes. So I love that about this. And you can just put any kind of canvas, right? There's some really interesting things going on. Yeah, look at that. Not impressed by Zoom bombers. Ooh, yeah, can't think, need coffee. Crying red tears. Nice. Yeah, so, oh, is this holding up the white flag here? That's alert. This is holding up the white flag, yeah. Yeah, Mary Lee, you'll get access to my slides. So you have this slide and it has the image with the Instagram template that was on there. So that's, you know, it's a good one. And then you can just change the editable stuff. So so that's a drawing response. So now let's take it a little different, right? So you can put your phones down right now. But let me ask you a question. Were you lost at any time in tabs? Were you doing the Neo, like, you know, instead of dodging bullets, you're dodging slides? Were you doing any of that stuff, Neo from the Matrix? Like the tab windows? No, right? Not lost. So what did you think about that? Like one screen, right? Answer questions, look at what's going on. Answer questions, what's going on, right? Kind of cool. That's like one of my favorite ways to do that. But you can zoom in, right? Allison, it has a tiny screen, but you can zoom in too, right? And really, like, it is a different design if you know what kind of questions you're going to be answering if you're only using mobile. Like, how do you design that? You know, you don't want to make the images too complicated. So, but remember, you can pinch that out. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to go and get in the little sidecar and do a teacher led. That was also teacher led, but we're going to do it on our tab right now. So Isaiah, would you be willing to drop that link in there? If not, I can drop it in here. So now let's open up a tab that you have there on the computer. Yeah. So we're going to put the phone down for right now. Jump onto the computer. Easy like easy E, that's what I'm saying. Throw it in the gutter and go buy another, right, Raul? So jump onto the Peardeck, and then I'm gonna play some music, and while we get transitioned between that, all right? So let's see, what do we got here?
This is a story about control. My control. Control of what I say, control of what I do. And this time I'm gonna do it my way. I hope you enjoy this as much as I do. Are we ready?
You're welcome, Allison.
I am. 'Cause it's all about control. And I've got lots of it.
So right about now is when, like, people, you know, this, the present mode gets out of full screen. So here's some quick tips for that's a great private comment, Dan. When Zoom takes over your screen, it's like, all in your face, hit escape. That pops it back there, right? To like manageable, not maximized. And then if you're on a PC, you're really gonna wanna go Alt Tab to toggle between your windows. So you can go like Zoom to the Peardeck tab to whatever, to your Gmail or something. Alt Tab. And then if you're on a Mac, it's gonna be Command Tab, right? So Alt Tab on PC and Command Tab on Mac to toggle between windows, like if, right? Yep, it works for Chromebooks, and it's Alt Tab on Chromebooks also. So if you're not about the hotkeys, you need to start being about the hotkeys, because that one, Alt Tab, like, it's gonna save sanity of people, because there's a lot of frustration with that point alone. That's a pain point, right? So Alt Tab, Command Tab, right? How are we doing? I'm seeing some people be like, yeah, I got that, right? How many people just like fit, like realize that is an easy way of navigating between these. Because if it's one person, then I'm happy I did my job. Command. Yeah, Command Tab is it on the Mac. Command Tab on the Mac toggles between Zoom. Yeah, so I'm not sure if it's a different setting, Katie, but Alt Tab on the PC, Command Tab. Okay, so are we good? Do we have a tab with Zoom? Do we have that open on your tab? Yes, cool. So let me show you something right here. Can you guys see my whole screen up here? And then can you see my Peardeck tab over here? That's highlighting presentation session. Yep, okay. So here's what I want you to do now. Here's another little tip. Because like sometimes if you're like me, you have a lot of tabs open and even Alt Tab, Command Tab might still get me lost because I don't know where I'm at. So if you right click on your tab and then go to pin, right click and go to pin tab right here. When you click here, go to pin. And then what does that do? It does this here. And it docks, this pins your tab. See how it pinned Perry over here? It slams your tab over here. It like docks your boat, like docking your boat to the side so you know where it's at. So I always know my Peardeck tab is right there. So just so you don't lose that one too, like dock your boat, dock your pin to there. And then the, it's really hard when people private message me because then I gotta get off of it. To message everybody, so Pro Mouse is the tool that I'm using with the purple light and the zoom this, and then this scribble tool. Okay, so just that's Pro Mouse. It's on the Mac. I'm not sure if there's something like that okay, now I'm lost in Zooms. Hold on. Okay. So now. What I want to show you is we're going to go synchronous, but why is synchronous right? Synchronous is I'm going to show you the same thing. I've already showed you every tool, every kind of response there is, except for this one here, the embed website tool. Like the website tool is the business right now is what I'm saying, because you can embed anything in there, not just a website. Hey, go read this. Hey, here's a Kahoot. Hey, here's a quizzes. And you're all in the same place. So what I'm gonna do is I'm not even gonna like do a teacher paste a desktop lesson because you already saw what that looks like. And it's basically gonna be the same thing. I don't wanna waste your time. We only got limited time. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna let you drive and show you how asynchronous learning, like how in the middle of a teacher-led session, I can switch it to student-led and let you drive, okay? So I want you guys to do slides 19 through 23. And what I'm gonna do is, you guys see down here these three dots? I lost the chat. Yep. Okay, three dots right here. And then now I'm gonna go from teacher paste to student paste, and I'm gonna release the Kraken, let you guys do slides 19 through 23, and then I'll see you on slide 23 in about like 5 minutes, something like that, okay? But I can tell how you're doing. So just get an experience there. So turn it on. Now you should be able to drive on your own. So I'm gonna,
All right.
That was a little crazy. We went kind of crazy right there. So see how now you should not be able to edit right now because I just locked student paste. Do you guys see that? So no more. I'm back to Janet Jackson control, right? So I wanted to point out this website here first. Did maybe not everybody got to that, but did you guys, if you didn't, are you seeing the word cloud that you guys created from this word cloud that's created from all of your responses? Mentimeter is dope for this, right? Just think about like, and I think there's other ones like Poll Everywhere does that. I like Mentimeter. It's got some cool stuff. And so I'm going to show you how to do this. This is not hard. I'm just telling you right now. Like, but I want to point out one thing before I go over here. So I'm going to go to the dashboard, back to the dashboard here. And I don't know if you saw, if you come back to Alt Tab or something and come back to my Zoom screen, but I was able to leave feedback for some folks in here. Like, this is the dashboard when you go to teacherpeardeck.com and log in. And so I can click on, like I saw Katie's response, and you can either star them. You're like, hey, Victoria, I'm gonna star those. And if you star those, that means that those are gonna be the first ones that show up when I show responses, right? At the top. So like highlighting, you know, exemplar answers, because if you don't have time to scroll through all of them. And then I go to leave feedback. And then, you know, I talked to Katie, she said, oh, I'm not in a classroom. And I'm like, yeah, I feel you, Katie, I'm not in a classroom too. But I've been lucky enough to get some classroom time teaching some students at a court school. So we can have a conversation going back and forth. That's the awesome thing. Like, you can give that feedback during that asynchronous time. I would model this during like everything else, model it synchronously, everything before we release the hounds, right? Because our kids, we need to make it super simple, super clear. So let's see. What about this slide? How many of you guys thought this slide was interesting right here? This number line explore slide right here. That's pretty dope, right? Allison, I love FET, right? So right about now, I'm hoping that you guys should be like, oh, wait a minute. This is cool. I just embedded an activity, and all that was a link to that activity, right? I mean, the one thing is, I don't have a dashboard to see what you all did. That's kind of next level. I don't know, you know, I don't think the only way you'd be able to do that is like Go Guardian, maybe. But I can, you notice how it's one link. I'm not asking my kids to pop out to another tab. It lives in Peardeck. So think about all the things that you use, all those other things that you talked about, like a Quizlet, a Flipgrid. You can embed a Flipgrid, and that just, it's gonna be boom. A Google Form, a Google Slide, right? Anything that is a link that lives on the web, you can embed that, right? A Jamboard. Just think about the activities that you can design. And Selena, Peardeck does have pre-made lessons, right? Okay, so I wanna make sure what's our time, Isaiah, 10:40? We got 7 minutes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I want to, talk about one thing and then do a quick demo and show you guys how easy this is. So one thing that I love to do is put a link to a Google slide in the website feature, that website push. And like, this is my favorite template, the notice and wonder, because you can notice and wonder about everything. And then I send kids into breakout rooms, and then I tell them, okay, if you're on breakout room number 4, then your team is gonna be on this slide, you replace your names, and then you guys, one person shares the screen and everybody else, you know, gives input, and that way it's super engaging. There's a focused conversation instead of like just being in a Zoom and like, hey, what tab are we supposed to be on? I didn't get the link. Did you get the link? Only one person needs the link. And then this is, when you're doing this, you put this into grid view because you are able to, see all the activity of your kiddos that are in here. You can be like, oh, I see like there's a couple people on this slide, there's a couple people over here. And if they're not started yet, then that gives you a hint. Okay, I could jump in. I need to jump into this Zoom, to this breakout room, you know, number four because nothing's going on in there and I need to go give them some help instead of like doing a random guess, right? So using Google Slides to link as a breakout room, you don't need Zoom to, I mean, you don't need Peardeck to do that because I've done it just without Peardeck and just drop that link. But with Peardeck, it makes it easier because they don't have to click a link. You're giving them the link, right? So that's what's really nice. So I'm going to give you a quick tutorial before we finish. We got 5 minutes. So I'm going to show you like how easy this is to, right? So take a look right here. How do I do this sorcery? Basically, you have to get the add-on, right? In a Google slide, you just click add-ons, go to Peardeck, whenever Google slide you have. If you don't have it, you're gonna go to manage add-ons. So, and I'll show you and I'll build one right now. So if I go to, I'm gonna add this slide. Can you guys see my blank Google slide? Yes? Thank you, Sandhya. I miss you, Sandhya. All right. So
do that always.
Yeah. We need to hang out more, Sandhya. I need to go to San Jose. So if you don't have the Peardeck add-on, you're gonna go to get add-ons and it's the first one that comes up. Then when you get that, this Peardeck for Google Slides add-on is gonna show up, or this thing too. This one doesn't always work for me, so I always just do add-ons and go to this one. And then when you do that, this little panel comes up and it shows you like how to add stuff. Like the pre-made lessons that someone was talking about, you can go to the template library and then there's like bell ringers, stuff like that. There's content specific ones. I'm gonna click a math one. You could have your number line, right? Let's see, I like that number line where you could have a graph. And what that does is it inserts a slide with Peardeck slide already. See this little bar at the bottom means it's interactive, and then you could type in your equation. But I rarely use that. I like to add the question here, right? Like does pineapple belong on pizza, right? So the way you do that is that's a multiple choice. So I've got to go over here back from the template. And then this is the magic right here. Like this spot right here, that's where I live right there. This would be a multiple choice. So I would go, heck yes, of course. So those are the only two options right there for that answer, right? So that's a multiple choice. And if you notice, this little bar means that it just got Peardeck, that's interactive. But here's the thing, I like to move that bar down because sometimes it gets in the way of your image. Like remember I had my mood meter? Sometimes that thing covers the mood meter. So I drag it down here. If you delete it, no more Peardeck, no more interactivity. So don't delete it, but just drag it down. And then here's, I'm gonna show you, go to this Jamboard, right? So this is a website push, and what do? Just click the website. So like the FET and the Mentimeter, I just make this a website, and then I just paste in like whatever Jamboard. I'm not gonna use a Jamboard, I'm gonna use this Google Slide, but you paste in whatever link you want it to go to, and then here's the thing is, you're gonna know, not all links work. You're gonna know if it shows you a preview right here. I can do that and then it's gonna work. But if it doesn't work, then you gotta let Peardeck know like, hey, this website doesn't embed, and then they'll fix it like after a while. Like they're pretty good about that. So you update the slide, but just think about all the things you can embed there, right? Jamboard, you know, quizzes, Flipgrid, you know, all that stuff. So that was like, a sprint to the end there. But if there's any questions, I'm gonna hang around for a little bit more. And I would love to answer your questions, but I know there's like rocking sessions to go to, so.
I'm gonna go ahead and push your session resources out, okay, Ed?
So thank you so much, Ed. I thought I knew a lot about Peardeck, but I got so many resources today. I'm going to give you a whole bunch of resources. I got Ed's music playlist, his slides presentation, and you can also click on the schedule to go to your next session. Thank you so much, Ed.
Yeah, and then last thing, I want to share if you haven't used one already, there's a 3-month premium trial for Peardeck that should work there if you haven't used it already. But let me know, tweet it out. I think it's pretty easy. If you're using slides already, it's like, just throw some of that hot sauce on there. The pre-used slide, yeah. Nope, that's good question, Victoria, but yeah, each session is new. It's like Desmos almost, if you use Desmos, but no, we don't give students access to the slideshow. You just give them a new presentation session. Oh, you know what? That's what I forgot to show you. Hold on. Let me show you one more thing before you guys go. So that's how can you guys see my slide now? Once you Peardeck your stuff, you don't click present from here because that's Google. You click present from here, right? This is the one, so same Google slide. Basically, if I have 5 different classes I want to do this same lesson for, I'm going to hit this 5 different times so that it gives me 5 different codes. So start a new session. And then this was the page that I, kind of the screen that came up before. So, and then this is your code. You can also invite your class, go to Google Classroom. I hope that meant Sandia, you rock. So I'll stick around for a little bit. If anybody wants to unmute, I like, you know, I enjoy chat, but I enjoy this thing called, you know, person-to-person communication.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Can you, if you don't finish this session, can you go back to the old one?
As a student?
As a teacher, if you want to present again, the same one, but you didn't go through the whole thing, can you go to that same one?
Yes. Yeah. When you go to peardeck.com and then log in as a teacher and then go to sessions, it shows all of your active sessions.
Okay.
And then the only time you can't is when, you know, the 3 dots that I showed you at the bottom where it turned off instructor and toggled between instructor and student paste.
Yeah.
Like right there is where you end the session. And then that like closes the lid. And it sends an email to every kid with a Google Doc that summarizes all their responses. It's called the takeaways. But once you do that, you can't go back in.
Okay.
But if you don't close it, you can go back in, unlock it, turn it student paced, teacher paced.
And there's a lot of good free features, right?
Oh, you can do everything that you need to do. Like,
all right.
Yeah.
Is the template library free?
Yes. Yes.
Thank you so much for all your help. That was awesome.
You're welcome. I'm on Twitter. If you have any more questions, you get lifetime customer support.
Oh, yeah. What's your handle?
At Ed Campos Jr.
What is it?
It's in the chat at Ed Campos
Jr. Ed Campos Jr.
Oh. Yep.
Okay, cool. Thanks.
You're welcome.
That was great. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Ed. I'll go ahead and stop recording right now.
Okay.